I just wrote out a little bit of the thing, and hopefully you can bear with me. But as you know, I'm here to announce that I will not be returning to Kansas State. I am happy to tell you I have two special job opportunities ahead of me. First, to be a full-time husband to my amazing wife, Megan, who for the last 42 years has waited for me, waited on me, and waited on others for me. Now it's my chance, hopefully, to wait on her. My second job opportunity is to be a grandpa to four very active grandkids. When I came to K-State, I told many people my number one goal was to be a great grandfather. Hopefully, I can live up to that goal. When change happens like this, the people that are most affected, but probably the most overlooked, are the players. I just met with our players earlier this morning to tell them the news, but I also emphasized to them my number one priority right now is to help them through this difficult situation and hopefully help them move forward to new and better things. I hugged and had to share tears with many of our players. And I emphasize again that I'm there for them, and that'll be my priority over the next couple days to help them. My next concern is helping our staff, who has dedicated endless hours to K-State basketball. They have families that they have to take care of, and it is my goal and concern to help them hopefully get jobs. I apologize to them last night for not fighting for them 3 years ago after we went to the Elite Eight and won the Big 12 again to protect them with long-term deals. Hopefully K-State will do the right thing and take care of them for what they've done for the university. I truly love K-State. It was amazing to me when I arrived at K-State, and I've told this many times, how many coaches, ones that were fired, ones that left, told me I would love Kansas State and Manhattan. As I expressed last night after the game, I'm really proud of what we've done and accomplished here. And I still want K-State to be successful. Earlier in the season, one of the social media people asked how we can get more people in the stands. I would tell you and challenge you, just like I do to myself and to our players, you might look in the mirror. There's no doubt winning helps. I know that, everybody knows that. But the negativity that surrounds K-State sports at times is really, really sad to me. This is the only school that I've been associated with that I am afraid to give our recruits and have them connected with our social media, because what they will hear and see. I know other coaches in our department feel the same way. Hopefully that can change. Maybe with the new coach and everybody can be positive about K-State and K-State athletics. I want to thank John Curry and President Schultz for 10 years ago, ironically meeting me in New Orleans at the Final Four and bringing me to K-State. I also appreciate the loyal support of President Myers, who was in our locker room and lived every play, cheering for us every game. It's been an amazing 10 years for Megan, my family, and I to be associated with K-State and the Manhattan community. We have made lifelong friends and appreciated the love and support of the K-State fans. I'm not sure right now what my future is in front of me. As I said before, I hopefully can be a more caring husband and also be a loving grandfather. I have a strong faith and always have been blessed by God's plan in the past, and I believe something good will happen. Many have asked me and encouraged me to tell me that I'll continue to coach. We'll see about that. I know when I got back last night and told my wife the situation, she said, "You're not done," and said, "Don't tell people you're retiring." Maybe there's some AD out there that would appreciate a coach that graduates players, wins championships, supports the university, and embraces the community, and maybe brings some good players with them and has a successful program. I appreciate everybody. I appreciate K-State Nation. It's been an unbelievable pleasure to be the coach at Kansas State. And I hope I can always come back to Manhattan and enjoy Manhattaness and the people that are part of it. Again, thank you. Appreciate everybody.
Thank you, Coach. We'll go to questions now. We'll start with Kellis.
Hey, Bruce, sorry I had to go out this way for you, but thanks for all the help over the years. It was fun covering you. I just wanted to say that up front. What was it like? What were the discussions with Gene? How did that all come about?
Over the last I mean, I'm not getting into that. I just, you know, it's just, it happens. It's been a long two months, to be honest. You know, the COVID was very hard. I wasn't around the players for 11 days. We had 6-7 players you couldn't practice. A lot of painful nights, a lot of tears, a lot of prayers. But, you know, we survived. I was hoping for the players' sake that, you know, we could have a good finish. I think we are capable, but obviously it seemed like every game something happened that, you know, didn't go right. And, you know, it's you know, it's you always wish you could have done better, but it didn't happen. So, you know, all we can do is just, you know, help the players, help our staff, and then be there for our families.
I also wanted to ask you, you guys had the program going at such a high level after your first 7 seasons, and then it teetered off the last 3. In hindsight, is there anything you wish you'd done differently to keep that momentum going?
I mean, I don't know. It's, you know, I thought the year after the championship, you know, we were close. I think some, you know, you wish some of the guys would have been more connected. And that year, obviously last year, COVID, the young team regrouping was, you know, in a really good league was tough to deal with. Obviously we made progress. I don't know how many coaches have reached out to me and said, "You made some of the biggest improvement in the country." You know, and, you know, so we made big strides, but, you know, we needed to make a little more strides, and that's, you know, it's just tough. You know, it just sometimes, you know, the injuries, my wife calls it the curse of the cats. And I'm not sure what it was, but just that's sometimes how life is. And you know, credit to our players, our staff for always getting up and meeting the challenge and doing what, you know, what they needed to try to win. And we just, you know, as I said, it was even last night, Mike has that wide open 3, shoots 40% from 3, makes that thing. We go up, the place gets excited. Probably we get the momentum, but we miss it. They go down and run off 3 or 4 straight baskets, and, you know, we couldn't get a win.
And last one for me, if you were recommending this program to another coach, what would you tell him? What kind of potential do you think is still here?
Well, I think you don't know what is going to happen with the players, obviously. You know, the portal changes everything. I think that's every school in the country. But, you know, K-State's a good place. And, you know, we got, you know, it's not easy to recruit to because it's hard to get to. We don't have a great recruiting base. It's a hard job. And, you know, but it's a great job. And what we've always said, once we get guys there, we always had a chance to get them. But it was tough getting there. I would tell you that I know I'd probably put in more days recruiting than probably any other coach, maybe in the country. I had some people tell me I went out more days than anyone else. Guys like Drew Timmy, I saw as many times as you could. EJ Liddell, Jared Allen. I mean, I could go on and on. Guys that we recruited. And, you put in the time. Jeremiah Robinson Earl, I saw him win 3 state championships, freshman, sophomore, junior year. Sometimes you get fortunate with players like Dean and Barry. If you're going to come here, you better come here to work because you got to find guys. And now with the portal, you hope that, it probably changes everything, I guess, a little bit, makes it a little easier. Obviously, we took advantage of it this year.
Thanks, Bruce. And enjoy your time with the grandkids.
Thank you.
Next question to Michael.
Good morning, Bruce. How much of a toll have the last 6 games, and for that matter, the last 3 seasons taken on you?
I told the coaches last night and the players, I probably thought I had more energy and zip this year, watch more film late into the night, some of it because I couldn't sleep, but put more time and than I've done in a long, long time. And, did it take a toll the last 2 months? Yes. Because you wanted to have the guys be successful, it just kept going against you. You kept hoping, praying that things would go our way, and it didn't. So, but I love coaching. I love the players. My favorite time is writing up practice. My second favorite time is being at practice. And my third favorite time is interacting with the players after practice. So, that part of it is still my love. If I don't coach again, we'll have to see on that. I'll be teaching somewhere with some kids, working on fundamentals or something, because that's all I know and that's all I love. Might be my grandkids, but I'll be out there doing something.
And are you leaving the door open if some opportunity would arise for next season?
I think I said that. Yeah, I think I said that.
And coming here, working through Coach Katie, obviously you had a background of knowledge about K-State. Just where do you think you fall within the lineage of Hartman, Winter, Kruger, and all those previous coaches?
I think I answered that last night. We've done some pretty good things. It's been 45 years and only 2 championships. And I'm proud of that. And I did it with supposedly the other guys. I did it with our guys. I did it the right way. I graduated people. We went to the Elite Eight. There is a special group of coaches, though. And the one thing I begged and asked for was K-State now, not we anymore, needs to really promote our history. I fought for Tex Winter Drive. I asked for Lon Kruger to be honored. I've asked for Jacob Pullen and Michael Beasley and Rodney Magruder, and then hopefully D. Wade and Barry Brown to have their banners up. There hasn't been a banner put up in a long time. I asked for the coaches to be acknowledged, that the great lineage of coaches that you just brought up, from Tex Winter to Jack Hartman to Jack Gardner, their names should be up in the rafters to really promote K-State basketball. That's important. And I hope somebody listens. I hope they do it. Obviously, they can listen to me because I asked many times. Hopefully, they'll do it in the future.
Thank you, Bruce. I appreciate your time as always.
Thank you.
We'll go to Todd Lebo.
Hey, Coach, just a question about last night. I mean, you obviously had that long speech at the end of the press conference. Was that said because you knew that was going to be the end for you, or was that the catalyst afterwards, timing-wise? Did you find out afterwards that you were going to resign?
I think I've been preparing for this for a long time, and I told one of the administrators, he said, do you really want to go through this? And I said, yes, I have a good answer for everybody. And I hope I impacted, obviously, I can't tell you how many text messages from coaches, from players, former players, you know, and I spoke from the heart. Hopefully I spoke the truth, and hopefully it meant something to somebody. I know it did. And I can't, my phone kept buzzing till 3 a.m. and then started again at 6. And I haven't even, and I got calls that I can't even answer from, you know, Coach Katie keeps calling me. I haven't been able to even respond to him, and Tom Izzo, and on, Rodney Magruder, the players, Brian Cardinal, you know, it's just endless. You know, it makes me feel good because I told the players, I got into coaching, got into teaching, because my dad and mom, they thought there was no better life than to help others. And that's been my goal. And hopefully I've impacted people and helped them with their lives. So now they can help others. Everybody in life needs love. I was blessed with amazing parents, blessed with an amazing wife and family. Everyone needs hope. You see it in the Ukraine right now. I would tell anybody listening, please, you can help. I just sent stuff to help people I know over that I've done clinics with. And everybody needs hope. And then everyone needs a purpose. And I think that became so obvious during COVID. You know, and hopefully I can find some purpose here in the last chapter, but we'll see what happens.
And I noticed you thanked John Curry and, you know, the previous president and all that. I didn't hear you mention Gene Taylor. Is that an omission by...
John and President Schultz brought me here. President Myers, obviously, and then Gene, I appreciate Casey Scott. Gene, just to, you know, transition. It's not easy when you got a new coach. I told him last night, appreciate that he stuck with me. Obviously, he got to enjoy an Elite Eight and a Big 12 championship, but doesn't happen very often. And then also Casey Scott, who really was a positive liaison in between when John left and Gene came and helped us. And I always remember, and I said it at people told me one of the most special moments in Bramlage history, we celebrated the Big 12 championship, winning against Oklahoma, at Casey Scott had the, you know, forethought to not have the state tournament that year so we could honor our seniors. And then obviously it ended up being a magical day and moment to celebrate a championship.
Thank you, Coach. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Next question to Mitch Fortner.
Yeah, Coach, you mentioned the social media and how you felt, you know, you didn't want your players looking at it because it was so negative, but I mean, did you feel personally disrespected by some of the fan base, or did you also feel maybe at the start you never got a fair shake by some people?
There's no doubt some people have said that to me. I still remember I walked in, there were protests. They wanted Doug Gottlieb as the coach or something. It was the most ridiculous thing I ever heard. You know, I talked last night about 13 winning the championship. No one, you know, I didn't get credit. But as I said, you know, I heard from every one of those guys today and last night. They're probably my closest group and players. They come back. You know, they love Manhattan. They love K-State. They appreciated being welcomed back. You know, and you know, it's not just me. There's other coaches in our department that feel the same way. And I didn't say the players. I said recruits. Because usually you want the recruits connected with your so you get the love. But when there's so much negativity out there, I'm not sure you even want it. So that it's that part. I'm just trying to help the next coach. And, I don't think sometimes somebody thinks they're doing something or they got some point to prove, but they're really hurting the whole program, to be honest. So, I love K-State and I want it to be successful. And, can only wish the best for all the coaches.
Thank you, Coach.
Yep.
I will do one last question to Mason.
Bruce, when you look back at your time at K-State, whenever, more reflection down the road kind of kicks in, what one specific memory or moment will stick out to you as kind of the embodiment of your 10 seasons at K-State? It could be something major or something minor that none of us have any clue ever happened.
I don't think there's any doubt the Oklahoma winning the championship was special. Losing at Oklahoma State and still coming home, and I never in my wildest dreams thought Kansas would lose to Baylor. And my wife and I were walking our dog. The baseball game was going on. We're close to at that time we were in a little town home close to the stadium, and we heard horns and fireworks, and then my phone started buzzing, and I all of a sudden I like grabbed my phone. I said, something must happen. And there John Curry called me and said, Coach, congratulations on the championship. And I kind of was numb to it, to be honest. So it was special, but there's no doubt to go to the Elite Eight and do it without the best player on our team. It was one of my proudest, coaching moments. To not have Dean and still do that was really, really special. I just obviously wish, I said my goal was to be a great grandfather, which it still is. My dad never got to be a grandfather, passed away early. My second goal was to get K-State back to the Final Four. We got close. We didn't get there. Hopefully sometime in the future they can enjoy that, because it is very, very special.
Okay, we'll do one last one with Grant, and then we'll be done.
Hey, Coach. I want to ask something you said about yesterday. Yesterday you said that 2013 team was one of your most together teams as far as how you felt you got yourself into that team. So I want to ask, what made them stand out as that team that is one of the most together teams that you had?
I think more than anything, I guess my whole word would be connected. We stayed connected. We both, all of them, obviously Shane being on the staff, from Rodney to DJ to Jordan, Martavius, Omari, we went through an unbelievable, I think the transition and our staff, how we welcomed them and embraced them and cared for them. And, I think they really appreciated that. Will, I don't want to miss somebody. Will Spradling was so, so important. Angel was, that was one of my sad moments when he left. But to have him and coach him for a year was amazing. And Dean and Barry's group is also really, really good, and they are together and enjoy each other. All those, but that group was, I don't know why, it's just, I guess maybe they're a little older and they still appreciate, and they're all back, for Thomas Gibson, like I said, come in with his kids and to the gym and hug me, and I can play with his kids, and, it's a special, special bond, special memories, and those guys will talk about that for a lifetime.
And then I wanted to ask, about, you brought him up a little bit, but Barry Brown, and how much heart did he have to get you guys to that, Elite Eight without what you were saying is your best player in Dean Wade at that time?
I think when somebody else asked about a special moment, and I've talked about it before, when Barry called his own practice on that Sunday, it I always tell him he saved our season. He saved, maybe saved our job. And I just joined this morning, and you know, this is amazing. And you know, you always appreciate that, those guys. I hate not to mention somebody, Cam, text this morning from overseas, and you know, all those guys there. Those groups are special, and that's what makes college sports special. To be honest, that's what I said from the beginning. You know, college sports is a business. The sad part is the players become pawns in it at times, and hopefully I can do what I can do to help our guys, and help them move forward in their life and have good careers and life. So,
and then the last thing I got for you.
Thank you, Grant. I got that lavender pullover for you.
Thank you,
I'll leave it at the office for you.
I appreciate that, Coach. Thank you so
much. Thank you. See you. Thank you, Tom. Thank you, Wyatt. All the best.